A small, delicate, and very rare seed landed in the northern forest. This was not just any seed, but a seed that held great beauty. This seedling was very special indeed, for it only grew once every 100 years. The journey begins today. It must find a home and plant itself firmly in the soil. When it reaches its maturity and has a full bud, with the graceful moves of a ballerina, it will unfold its delicate petals for the world to see. Nestled in the center of the bud is a single tiny seed. This seed will be released and ride the wind to a new location. In 100 years, it will spring forth and release a seed of its own. However, this time, the birth and offspring of this rare and delicate flower is in danger. Instead of landing in a clearing to take root and spring forth at its appointed time, the seed landed near a large oak tree. The limbs of the giant oak hid the much-needed sunlight and rain for the seed to grow properly. Slowly, the seed began its birthing process into the world. The ground was hard and taking root was not easy, but the seedling had a destiny, just as every seed before it. It must thrust its roots into the ground and reach up to the sun to begin its morphing into the beauty it was meant to be. The releasing of its precious cargo was of great importance for all future generations of its species. The seedling managed to secure itself in the soil and search for the much-needed rays of the sun. The sun's rays were everywhere, but not one could reach the sapling. Even the sun admired the sapling and knew of its destiny, for the sun had seen the journey of many before it. Soon, the sun began to set, and the sun began weeping for the sapling and its struggle to survive. The next day, the rain came, and the sun spoke to the rain and told it of the sapling's dilemma. No matter how hard the sun and rain tried, they could not reach the sapling. That day, the sun and rain felt great sadness. The sapling wept and looked up at the giant oak, tall and majestic. How strong it appeared, and its limbs lifted and spread out in an array of green, and the sapling was struck with awe. To die beneath such greatness was an honor, thought the sapling. The sapling bent at the stem and sighed. 3 days had passed now, and each day the sun tried with all its might to shine its rays upon the plant. The rain was so saddened by the sapling's situation, it refused to fall even upon the tall oak. It appeared as though the northern forest would be the resting place of the once rare and most beautiful flower in all the world. No more would such beauty unfold, nor would her seed be released and ride upon the wind. The tall oak felt an overwhelming sadness in the air and looked up at the sun through its thick branches. "What is it that causes such sadness?" he asked the sun. The story was then told of the sapling beneath him in the shadow of his branches. The great oak let out a growl. "How foolish of you, sun, and you too, rain. I see you hiding behind the clouds." The great oak looked down at the sapling and growled once more. "Why is it that you sat there withering away?" The sapling replies, "The rays of the sun and moisture of the rain cannot reach me, and I need them to grow." The great oak growls again, and the sapling shivers with fear. "Why is it you have not called out to me and let me know these things? If you had called out and spoken to me of your troubles, do you think I would not have listened? I tell you this, young sapling, I would have listened and heard, and then I would have done this." The sapling heard a rustle and gentle sound. Then a brightness surrounded him, and light sprinkles of rain began to moisten the earth beneath him. The sapling looked up and saw the sun and the rain smiling and rejoiced. The great oak had spread its branches and opened a gateway for the sun's rays and the rain to fall upon him. The great oak spoke again and said, "How foolish, young sampler. You sat upon the dry earth and would have perished if I had not felt the sun and rain sorrow for thee." The sapling replied, "But great oak, I could not get that which I needed to grow, for they were blocked from me." "No," replied the great oak firmly, "you deprived yourself of the sun and rain when you refused to open up and speak to me on this matter. I would have helped you sooner by opening my branches to let that which nourishes you through, if you had but opened up and spoke to me." The end. The moral of the story? Never fear opening up to someone, for how can you be helped if the problem is not known?